still counting the ballots for the vice chairs, but we're coming to what hopefully in the future will be one of the best things about our conventions and our off year. And Tony Hernandez and crew, right, have a new award that they want to introduce and give out. So Tony, our great congressional candidate from last year, thank you for thinking of this.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, 4th Congressional District Republicans. How are you? Before I get into the award, I just, many of you know, but Leona and I are expecting our first baby. Oh. Yeah. Really happy and blessed for that. So, and Leona's finally feeling better after the first trimester. During the course of the campaign, one thing that became very clear to me is that we spend a lot of time and a lot of energy on the few and the far negative things about the 4th Congressional. Another thing that I observed and noticed is the heart and soul of this district, the people, you, the volunteers, the activists, the donors, the bloggers. We are not giving enough attention to the people here about the hard work, the sacrifice, and dedication that many of you all make year in and year out with little to no thanks for this cause of liberty, for the cause of conservatism. So I took it upon myself, and Leona and I, we made the investment here to start a new award that's going to be handed out every spring on the odd year, and it's going to be awarded to the person from the previous election year. And it's going to be awarded to the person who demonstrates what this district is all about, what the volunteers are all about, the hard work, the dedication, the desire, the unifying spirit. And it's going to be awarded from the candidates, headed by the 4th Congressional U.S. House endorsed candidate. But really, all the candidates have input. And I talked to many, many of the candidates out there about various people who they thought that they wanted to nominate. And there were so many people that were named. I can't name everybody, but I'm certainly going to try to name a lot of the honorable mentions because, you know, we weren't successful in 2012. Many of us woke up on November 7th with a pit in our stomach, and that hangover lasted throughout November and December and January. Many of us drank too much or whatever it was. But the example that I want to give, and this person's one of the honorable mentions, is I remember receiving an email in mid-January. It was so cold outside. You know, I was feeling kind of down that day, and I get an email from Joe Salmon, who's the chair of SD53, and I think he's out there working as he usually is. But I remember he made the comment about the great candidates that he had in Woodbury, Pam Cunningham. We lost a great state senator, Ted Lilly, Andrea Kiefer. But he wrote, and I'll never forget this, he was fired up. He's like, we need to start our work now for 2016 to take our seat back. You know, and this is what this award is all about. The people who can rise from the ashes, the people who pick up their toys, they pick up their ball, and they want to get out there, they want to practice again, they want to play harder, they want to develop the strategy to win elections. And you can see Tim, he helped me, Tim Lodi, he's the chair of 64B, but he helped me with the design and the construction of the award. And it's in the shape of a puzzle. And this is the missing piece right here. It's our first award winner. But this is going to be given out every 2 years. So 2012, 2014, 2016, 2018, 2020. And really, this idea of long-term thinking in our district is going to come back. Because everything that we do right now, everything that we do next year, is building and building. And somebody mentioned momentum. And it's absolutely what we need. Because the political economic climate of this district, it changes. It changes with the economy, it changes with the tax rates, it changes with everything. So these people though are the honorable mentions. Dallas Pearson for all the work that he's done with the video, with everything. Kathy Roberts, she's not in the 4th anymore, but she did tons and tons of work. Joel Selwood, who helped out Stacey Stout's campaign, and we all hope that Stacey runs again because she is gonna be a representative. Jim Carter, Larson, Joe Salmon, Chris Salmon, Karen Bauman, countless work, Jake Duesenberg, Joseph Schultz, Pat Anderson for stepping up, Andrew West for all his photography work, Bev Applekowski for year in and year out dedicating her heart and soul to this district, Don Dickerson for the incredible work, he's the door knocking, lid dropping champion, I think, in this district. Karen and Linda Markowitz, Mitch Bird for everything that he's done, Matt Efforts, Amy Williams, Tim Loney, Steve Olson, Dr. Bob, Eric Ekstrand, Joe Remley, Danny Sermon for helping out the Andrew Ojeda campaign and building new seeds in the 64A, Tim Frappier, Aaron Larson, Jeanette Gudgel, Tom Polachek, I could go on and on, Chris Jacobson, Randy Larson, everybody, thank you for all the dedication, everything that you've done for this 4th District. It starts with belief, and we gotta believe that we can win. It starts right here. If you don't believe in the product that you're selling, we're not gonna sell it. But if we can believe it in our hearts and in our guts that what we stand for is gonna better the life of the people in the 4th, we're gonna win if we can communicate that. So without further ado, I would like to announce the 2012 first ever winner of the Candidates Award, Michelle Mankey. Her name came up over and over and over again in the various campaigns and candidates. The work that she did with her graphic design, her photography skills, she took part in multiple committees. She's out there, she was one of the people that rose out of the ashes of defeat and was immediately started thinking about what can we do to make this congressional district stronger? What can we do to point our guns and our arrows at the Democrats? And with that, we'll give Michelle the floor here. So Michelle, great job.
Wow. Now I know what it's like when they do the TV awards. Thank you very much. You know, for me, it is just a passion. And like I said before, it is all of you who inspired me. So I have to thank all of you. Thank you.
Yay! All right.
Got it, Andrew?
Yes.